You're watching UNICEF television. Ms. Radhika Coomaraswamy, Special Representative of the Secretary General for Children and Armed Conflict, visited Gaza during a four-day trip to the occupied Palestinian territory and southern Israel. She was in the region to assess the impact of the recent conflict on children, meet with relevant stakeholders, and advocate for the protection of children. Radhika listened in on a children's group session facilitated by UNICEF partner Palestinian Center for Democracy and Conflict Resolution.
My mother, my brothers, and my nephew died in front of me. I couldn't save them. I couldn't do anything. I suffer every day when I remember this. I can't forget it at all. It was very difficult for me. It was a big shock.
The extensive destruction to homes, hospitals, schools and power, water and sanitation networks also has a devastating impact on children.
I want my family back. My dad, my brother, more than anything, my uncles, my aunts, my cousins. They're all gone. I also want my house back.
According to the United Nations, nearly one-third of the 1,380 Palestinian casualties are children. And many of them have witnessed violence against their family members and are severely distressed.
I wish I could live in peace, not under bombs and shells, just like they live in peace. We want to live in peace as well.
Children in Gaza are in urgent need of humanitarian assistance, including the restoration of basic services and the immediate reconstruction of schools and hospitals. The UN has launched an appeal for $613 million to support 1.4 million Gazans over a nine-month period. UNICEF has requested a total of $34.5 million for child protection, psychosocial and education projects, as well as interventions for sanitation, hygiene and health. But the immediate need, as Ms. Coomaraswamy noted, is for aid agencies to gain better access to these young victims. This is Edward Belly, reporting for UNICEF Television. Unite for Children.